Hey everybody, it is March 30th. We are almost into April. It's unbelievable. It's just unbelievable how quickly this year is cranking along. Today's another kind of anniversary day. This will be my 500th video since March 23rd of last year. It's unbelievable. It's hard to believe I've done this many videos, but I've loved every minute of it. It's just been so much fun. And I thought I'd just I'm going to do something different today. This'll be long in the tooth, as the old saying goes. This all started, as I've said on a number of occasions, with me responding to some questions about some Phil Collins stuff that we did live, where people wanted to hear more defined bass parts in terms of sonics, because they were seeing the gigs in stadiums and stuff, and it's hard sometimes in those environments to really hear all details. So I started off by just playing songs of Phil's from our show. I ended up using the show that we did in Adelaide, Australia, and so each day I would put up another song and play along with them. I just thought today, I enjoy doing it so much, and I haven't done it in a long time. I've been focusing on immediate family songs because we're going to start rehearsing this coming Sunday, and I'm really excited about that. We're going to spend probably close to 3 weeks locked down, and we're our own bubble. Everybody's had their shots in enough time, and we're going to be in a place where it's just us. And we are going to play every day and kind of get all of our old material and current material under our fingernails. And then we're also going to be working on new material because we're going to go back in the studio. Even though our album is not released until August, we're going to go ahead and cut another album to have for next year because we've got a lot of material that's been building up. And so I'm really excited about that. So I haven't been playing this for a while. And I thought today, I'm going to play the whole show, Phil's show, from just as we did it in Adelaide. As we go along, I'll talk a little bit about it. But I love this tour. It was the Not Dead Yet tour. And I miss everybody so much. The band was so great on this with Daryl and Ronnie Carroll, Brad Cole, Nick Collins, my God, Richie Garcia, the horn section, the background singers, everybody on this was amazing. And it's just hard when these tours end to say goodbye. I've tried to stay in touch with as many people as I can. George Shelby, Dan Fornaro, Harry Kim, and Luis Bonilla were just the Vine Street Horns, an amazing horn section. And Bridget Bryant and Amy Keys and Lamont Van Hook and Arnold McCullough, just such a great vocal section. So I miss the crew. I miss all the guys and the girls from the crew, the caterers, everybody. And we had such a family going on. So I thought I'd just go ahead and play this show. And it's going to be long. This is going to be a long video, but you can come in, grab bits and pieces you want or whatever, or listen to it. And, you know, it's like kind of like being there, except without the parking hassles and the crowd. So we'll see how that goes. Now, when this show started, the whole band was behind a screen, and there was a chair in front of the screen with a couple of spotlights on it, and Phil would come out, wave to the audience, they'd go crazy, and he'd sit down in his chair because he's been dealing with these back and leg issues. So he pretty much did the whole show sitting on a stool. But for the first song, Against All Odds, the band was behind a screen. So we were playing, but we were unseen. The whole show was focused on Phil at this point. So I'm going to start with that one, and we're just going to cruise along and do the show. So I hope you enjoy. Here we go. Let's see how this all works out.
Oh.
That's the first song. Then we would go into the second song, and as this song would begin, the screen would rise and display the band prominently behind Phil at this point. So here we go. I haven't played these in a while. It's good for the mind. 500 videos.
Thank you.
And then at that point, then the horn section would come out on stage and it would kick some butt. Here we go. Missed again.
Yeah.
then we went right on into Hang In Long Enough. Big horn intro. Into a little bit of a like a Genesis world. Boy, trying to remember all this. Throwing it all away.
Thank you.
would let this ring at that point, and then it would go right into the very next song. So you'll hear it ending here. Boy, trying to remember these. a little rusty on these, but you get the idea. And then we did this little kind of medley here. Kick right into. Thank you. at the end of that song, Phil was going, did you say what? Did you say what? And he was walking around talking to the band, to the audience and everything. So that's why that one goes on so long. And then we did this beautiful Stephen Bishop song, and he brought Bridget Bryant down front, and she sat next to him, and they sang this beautiful ballad.
In Separate Lives.
I love the dynamics of the show. You know, you'd have intense, then you'd bring it down, then it'd come back.
You called me from the room in your hotel. All full of romance for someone that you met. And telling me how sorry you were leaving so soon, and that you miss me sometimes when you're alone in your room. Do I feel lonely too? Thank you.
Beautiful moment in the show. Then following this, there was a big, huge drum solo section with Nick Collins and Richie Garcia. Now, at the end of that, of the soloing, Phil would be sitting there and he would play a cajon with his hands, and Richie and Nick would come down with cajons also. And they would do like a triple thing together back and forth. And towards the end of that, Nick would then go back to the drum kit, and this, and they would come out of this solo, and we would go into this next tune. So you'll hear this. Getting the crowd clapping. Thank you. then, at that point, there was this incredibly intimate, beautiful moment of You Know What I Mean, where Nick came down from the drums and sat at the piano, and Phil came over and sat with him, and they did this song together, and it was really touching. It was filmed beautifully, and just to see father and son together was really great. And when that ended, we went into this. Hold on, there we go. This tremendous, like, beautiful lighting effects during this and everything. It's really pretty great. This is all Brad Cole. Remember, this is all just a board mix that I'm playing too. This wasn't, I mean, this was. In the board, but the crowd was going nuts when they heard the just little drum machine come in. I do mostly pedals during this.
Thank you.
It's so much more dynamic, you know, when you're there and it's cranked. And in the past, I would use Taurus pedals with and all kinds of shit. It was really great. And then it went right into, as soon as that ended,
thank you.
happens here. We hit that, but it goes right directly into the next song.
Come on.
end of the show. This is all. And we went right into, see if I can remember this one. This is digging deep today.
Thank you.
Buya bass in them there towards the end, but then we went right into it. Killing it. just killing it live. And then we went into this penultimate song. Oh no! It was Phil going, oh no!
Thank you.
And that was the end of the set. And then we had one encore, which was Take Me Home. And I'm going to save Take Me Home for a later date. And I'm going to be closing out when the time comes eventually to be shutting down this channel, which is hopefully years from now. I'll do Take Me Home as my penultimate song. But that we would come out and do that. And that was from our show in Adelaide. And how I miss all of those people. It's so weird playing all this again in a row like that. Every once in a while I come out and play the show just to do it. But like I said, I've been focused on immediate family material. So wrapping my head back around that was fun. 500. This is number 500. I figured I'd just throw in the kitchen sink on this one. So remember, tomorrow is the live stream, 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And Saturday is the one-on-one Skype and FaceTimes for the club members who signed up for that. And I took my pictures into Blue yesterday, and they are being scanned, and we're going to fix them up for printing. And I made a little video of the paintings just before I took them over to Blue. We've already done three paintings and a whole bunch of drawings, and those things have been up on my website, but these two. So after I get this video posted, maybe I'll stick that one up later. It'll be 501 will be the paintings. Just a little video of them so you can see what those are. They're really fun. Boy, I forgot about those. Boy, 50 plus years later, seeing them was pretty much of a trip, I'll tell you. And saying it's a trip is exactly right for the content of this. This is quintessential 60s. Man, it's far out. So I'm going to wish everybody a great day today. I've got some errands to run. Then I got a really important interview to do at 5 o'clock today. And with Brian Sebastian, I'm looking forward to that, and a great cast of characters, and things are getting interesting about possible getting the book to Europe, and we're still finishing up getting it to Japan, and lots of stuff going on. You know, I feel really fortunate to have every day be so busy, because if I wasn't busy, I'd be really, I mean, I'm out of my mind, but I'd be losing what's left if I wasn't this busy. So take good care. I will see everybody tomorrow, and again, thank you to everybody out there. Be very careful. Numbers are going climbing again because people are acting really irresponsible, and they're a little premature opening of a lot of things that people aren't protected yet. So thank you to all the people that are still in harm's way because of this kind of craziness. So I will see you all tomorrow. See how I'm going to check and see how this thing uploads. It's the longest thing I've ever put on YouTube, so we'll see if this all works. Here's hoping. Okay, so take good care, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.